Friends, in part 5 video, we are going to see the chapter real numbers exercise 1.2. So if you see in part 4 video, we have completed 3 problems in exercise 1.2. Now in part 5 video, we are going to continue the same exercise 1.2. I am starting from 4th problem. Okay, in the end of this video, if you see, I will give you the total assignment, you write and keep. Okay, now we'll start the problem. Given that HCF 306, 657 equal to 9. Find LCM 306, 657. What in question they are saying? They given the HCF value and they are asking us to find LCM. Clear? Now, we'll go for the solution. We know that what LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers, isn't it? LCM into HCF is equal to what? Product of two numbers. So LCM we don't know because they are asked us to find the LCM. If you see in this bracket, both the numbers are same. Okay, here also 306, 657. Here also 306, 657. Okay, now if you see, we don't know the LCM value, so we are writing LCM as such. Into what is HCF value we are having here? 9. So I am writing here 9 is equal to product of two numbers means what? Here, how many product? Here, one number, the another one is this number. Product means what? We want to multiply that two number. So we are multiplying 306 into 657. Clear? So next step, what this multiplication 9 will become? Divide. So in 9 table, if you cancel 306, how many times it will come? Means 34. Okay, so LCM is equal to 34 into 657. If you multiply, what we are getting? 22,338. So therefore LCM of 306, 657 is equal to 22,338. Clear all of you about this fourth question? Clear? This is very, very easy. They have given the LCF and they are asking us to find the LCM. Similarly, some question they will give you the LCM answer and they will ask you to find the LCF. The same model, the same procedure you are going to solve. Okay. Now we will see the fifth question. Check whether 6 power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Clear about this fifth question? What they are asking to show? Check whether 6 power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. What they are saying? Check whether 6 power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. 6 power n is what? For any natural number n means, instead of this n, you can give any number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. You can give any number. If you see this example, you will be clear. See here, 6 power n. Instead of this power n, I have given first 1. So 6 power 1 is nothing but what? 6. Instead of that n, I am giving 2. 6 power 2. 6 power 2 means what? 6 into 6, which is equal to what? 36. Then, for n, I am giving 3. Yeah, 6 power 3. 6 power 3 means what? 6 into 6 into 6, which is equal to 216. Okay, so whatever natural number, you can give the value as n. But what they are saying, when this digit will end with 0, which means what? Here, what is the end? We are ending with 6. Here also ending with 6. Like that, what number if you give the value of n, we will get 0, they are asking. Okay, clear about the question? Clear? First, we'll go for the solution. Step 1. Any number which end in 0 must have at least 2 and 5 as prime factor. Okay, if any number if want to end it with 0 means that number should have compulsorily 2 and 5 as a prime factor. Clear? Any number which end in 0 must have at least 2 and 5 as prime factor. Consider the number 10. Okay, So consider the number 10. So if you take the factor of, what are the factors of 10? 2, 1, 2, 5 and 10. Okay, so for that 10, what are the factors? We are having 2 and 5, so surely that 10 power n end with 0, but here 6 power n we are having. Clear? So any number which end in 0 must have at least 2 and 5 as prime factor. Okay, that is the first step. Now we'll see the second step. What value they are given? 6. So what are the factors of 6 first? 2 into 3, 6 power n. So I have also written 6 power n. So I am giving this here also whole power n. This n will go inside, 2 power n into 3 power n. Hence prime factor of 6 are, what are the prime factors of 6? 2 and 3. Okay, but what are condition? If any number which end in 0 means it should have what factor? 2 and 5. But what we are getting here? 6, 2 and 3. Since third step, since 6 power n does not contain 5 as a prime factor, isn't it? It has, 6 is having 2, but whether it is having 5? No. So what we are writing, in since 6 power n does not contain 5 as a prime factor. Okay, in 6 power n can never end in 0. Clear all of you? From the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we know that what? Prime factorization of every composite number is what? Unique. We have seen this fundamental theorem of arithmetic in part 4 video, isn't it? Based on that we have done what is LCM, HCF, everything we have seen. So, based on that only we are proving this. Clear all of you? One more time I'll explain, students. If any number, if they want to end with 0, means that number should have to have compulsorily the factor as 2 and 5. Clear? Yeah, the question is what? 6 power n. The 6 as the factor of only 2 and 3, it is not having the factor of 5. So, since 6 power n does not contain 5 as a prime factor, in 6 power n can never end in 0 by the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Clear? Clear all of you? Now we'll see the 6th question. Okay, in 6th question, we are going to see, explain why 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5 are composite numbers. Okay, we want to explain this number and this number are composite number. Okay, now we'll go for the solution. I have written this number separately, this side and that number here. Okay, so after writing the number, first thing you have to see which number is commonly we are having. Okay, if you see here, whether 7 is again repeating, no, 11 is also not, 13 is coming 2 times. So common number is what? 13. So you have to take the 13 commonly out. Okay, so after taking the 13 commonly out, you are going to write here 7 into 11 into. This 13 came outside, no. So 7 into 11 into what? This in, if you multiply here, what you will get? 13 into 1, 13 we will get. So I have written here into 1 plus this 13 came outside, so I have written plus 1. Clear all of you? Clear? This, since this 13 is, we have taken commonly out, so I am writing 7 into 11 into 1 plus 1. Clear? Afterwards, you should not add this 1 plus 1. What you have to do is, you have to multiply 7 into 11 into 1. 7 into 11 is what? 77. 77 into 1 is what? 77. Plus 1 you have to write as such. Then 13, this 13 I am writing here as such. 77 plus 1 is what? 78. In then, since prime here, 13 is what? Prime number. Since prime number 13 is multiplied with any number other than 1, it is a what? Composite number. This concept that we have learned. This concept we have learned in part 4 video, isn't it? Any prime number, if you multiply with any other number, Okay, you will get what composite number, but you should not multiply with 1. Clear? Since prime number, if this 13 is a prime number, the 13 is multiplied with what? The 78 is what? Composite number. So, since prime number, 13 is multiplied with any number other than 1, it is a composite number. Clear all of you? Now, you see this next part. 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. If you see here, which number is repeating again? 5. So, if you see here, 5 here also having, there also 5 I am having. So, you have to take commonly 5 outside. Clear? So, after taking the commonly outside, then the 7 into 6 into I have written on as such. When this 5 is outside, so I have multiplied with 1. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus that 5 is outside, so I have written plus 1. Clear all of you? Then 5 I am writing as such. 7 into 6. 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2. If you multiply, what we will get is we will get 1008. So that plus 1, if you add, what you will get? 1009 will get. So 5 is a what? Prime number. The same condition here also we are writing. Since prime number 5 is multiplied with any number other than 1, it is a what? Composite number. We have explained these two numbers are what now? Composite number. Okay, how? If you multiply any prime number with any other number other than 1, it is what? Composite number. Clear? Students, in exercise 1.2, all the problems are very, very simple. Only minute thing will be there. If you understand that, you will be very clear. Okay, now we'll see the 7th question. 7th question. There is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one around of the field, while Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. Okay, what they are saying up to this, what they are saying in the question, that is a circular path. Okay, in this path, Sonia taking 18 minutes to drive one round of the field. By that time, while Ravi is taking 12 minutes for the same field. Suppose they both start at the same point and at the same time and go in the same direction. After how many minutes will they meet again in the starting point? Clear? What they are asking? If they start both at the same point, same time, same direction, means after how many minutes will they meet at the same point, they are asking. Okay? I hope you all understood this question, isn't it? So, what they are asking? They want to meet again in the same position. Okay? So, again they are going to meet in the same position. We have to find here LCM. Clear all of you? We want to find here LCM. Okay, first, what is given in this question? Sonia takes how many minutes? 18 minutes. Ravi takes how many minutes? 12 minutes. Okay, what we have to find? Since they want to meet again in the same position, we have to find the LCM. LCM of 18 and 12 we want to find. So, if I am taking separately doing 18 here and separately doing 12 here. If you take 18, how many times the 2 table it will come? 9 2s are 18. Similarly, 3 table, 9 how many times will come? 3 3s are 9, 3 1. Similarly, 6 2s are 12, 2 3s are 6, 1 2s are 2. Okay, now what is the factors of 18 we are having? 2 into 3 into 3. Similarly, what are the factors of 12? 2 into 3 into 2. So, after seeing this, we have making the pair. So, 2 are having circle. Similarly, for this 3 also we are having pair. Since this 3 and this 2 is not having the pair, so we have to leave it. Now, LCM means what? The pair value we will write one time. 2 into this 3 into, if not having pair also, we will write one time. 3 into 2. Clear all of you? This 2 into 3 into 3 into 2. Clear all of you? So, 2 3s are 6. Similarly, there also 3 2s are 6. So, 6 6 are what? 36. So, the LCM of 18 and 12 is what? 36. Therefore, both Sonia and Ravi will meet again at the starting point after 36 minutes. Clear all of you? When they will meet after again at the starting point? 36 minutes. Clear? Students, with this our exercise 1.2 is over. I hope you all understood the exercise 1.1 and as well as 1.2. Isn't it, students? Most of you are sending your classwork. I don't want this to be sent in the assignment. Only what are the problems I am giving you assignment, that alone you take the screenshot and send in WhatsApp. Okay, I don't want what I am teaching in the class, you don't need to copy and you have to copy, but that you no need to send. I need only the homework problem. Put date and write the heading homework problem. If the part 5 means, for part 5 I will give you 4 assignment. Okay, you write the heading part 5, real numbers, exercise 1.2. What are the 4 problems you are having? One by one you write and then you send to me. Okay, I don't want this classwork part to be sent. I clear all of you? Students, 1 or 2 times you go through the video so that you will be very, very clear about this. Exercise 1.2 is very, very easy when compared to exercise 1.1. Exercise 1.1 is also easy, but more easy is exercise 1.2. Okay, now we will see the assignment problems. Students, in part 5 video, the first question in part 5 video, we have seen what are the problems, 4th sum, 5th sum, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th in exercise 1.2. We have seen 4 problems. Based on the 4 problems, I have given you this assignment. Okay, students, these assignments are very, very easy. Don't postpone your assignment. Whenever I am giving, immediately you submit the assignment. Only the assignment I need. I don't want your classwork. Okay. Now we'll see the first question. In assignment, given that HCF of 306,1314 is equal to 18. Okay. Find the LCM of the same number. We are given the HCF value and what they are asking? And they are asking to find the LCM. The same we find this in exercise 1.24. So the same model I have given you the assignment. First step, what you will do? LCM into HCF is equal to product of 2 numbers. Okay? LCM into HCF is equal to what? Product of 2 numbers. You have to find. You will do afterwards. Next, second question is what? Check whether 15 power n can end with 0 for any natural number n. What they are saying? They are asking to check whether 15 power n can end with 0 for any natural number n. Students, what I told, if any number which end in 0 must have at least 2 and 5 as prime factor. I told you not. Yes, if any number which end in 0 must have at least 2 and 5 as prime factor. Okay, you have to see, you have to check whether 15 is getting the prime factor as 2 and 5. If it is not getting, you have to write 15 power n does not contain the 5 as a prime factor or 2 as a prime factor. Which number is not coming, that number you have to write. Similar, the same model, the third sum is also 8 power n. You have to write the prime factor of 8. You have to check whether it is, we are getting the factor 2 and 5. If it is not getting, if what number you are not getting, that number you write does not contain 5 as a prime factor or does not contain 2 as a prime factor. Like that you have to write. You see that the fifth question in exercise 1.2, the same model, this 2 problem. Okay, now fourth question. Explain why 7 into 11 into 13 plus 11 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 3 are composite number. You have to see which number is repeating, 11. So take that 11 commonly out. Remaining terms you write inside. Afterwards you write 11 is what? Prime number. So our concept is what? They are telling, since prime number, any number is multiplied with any other number other than 1, it is a what? Composite number. That line you have to write. Similarly, this here what you will take commonly out? 3 you will take commonly out. And you have to do. Next, fifth question. 3 bells at interval 9, 12, 15 minutes respectively. Okay? 3 bells at interval of 9, 12, 15 minutes respectively. If they start tolling together at after what time will they next toll together? Again, with this question is what? Same model as like that on the sports track they are running, the same model this one. Okay, after what they are asking? After what time will the next toll together? Okay, they are asking, which means what? We have to find the LCM. LCM of 9, 12, 15. Separately you find the LCM of 9, 12 and 15. After finding, you find the LCM. That is your answer. Clear all of you? Students, try this 5 assignment problem. This 5 assignment problems are very, very easy. I have given the based on the part 5 video exercise 1.2. No, we have seen 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. Based on that 4th sum only model, I have given this. You see that video thoroughly, then you start doing this assignment. Okay. Thank you, children. We'll see the next session in part 6 video. Thank you so much.